Yeah. I prefer to eat my own lunch.
What about milkshake? Would you drink someone else's milkshake?
It depends on whether I like them or not.
What if it was my milkshake?
I think we better just leave that to find out. That's not a sentence.
No. I mean, last
sorry,
time
everybody.
Last time I brought my milkshake and you didn't
get
even
out.
Drink yours, so.
That's why I asked about it earlier.
To be fair, I was pressed for time, and I went to McDonald's to get my milkshake.
Yeah.
No great loss.
Well...
Yeah, it's pretty, those things aren't very good.
Yeah, it was not...
Your brain was helping you out on that one.
I went to Taco Bell for dinner today, and they did not have the Diablo fire sauce or whatever. So I almost, like, walked out, because that's what I wanted.
I do that.
So tonight's sometimes. Totally random drink of choice is Andy Gator. There's a Gator in every bottle.
A full one?
Yeah, full Gator.
Wow.
Gators and Gators don't get along.
It's a Doppelbock? Oh, it's Doppelbock?
So it's a Doppelgator?
Yeah, a Doppelgator.
See?
Yeah.
Excellent.
It's pretty good.
Thank you, Ryan.
It's a little zesty. It's a zesty beer. Mm-hmm.
I bought FTL. Started playing FTL. Yes,
wait, is this your first... You haven't played it before?
You poor soul.
I've watched him
you
play.
You poor soul.
Isn't it awesome?
It's a lot of fun if I could stop dying.
You're not going to do that.
Yeah, that's not going to have any sense.
And you have the advanced edition, so you don't have a nice ramp. Well, actually, can you play the normal edition?
You can
Are you doing the normal?
I'm playing the normal.
Mm-hmm. That's probably a good idea, because the advanced edition adds a lot of complex things.
Yeah, it's on the, when you select it or whatever, it's like advanced, recommended for... whatever experience players or whatever.
You can play an easy to unlock a lot of stuff too, but who wants to do that, right?
Well, I'm on. I think I started on easy.
Yeah.
I'm on normal. I don't remember. I can't remember what level I started on.
Hey, Polo. Come here.
I was doing okay.
Over here.
Like, I got to like the third sector, and then. I think I made a bad choice too. So where's the slug sector and those guys?
To be fair, you could have just as easily not made a bad choice.
Yeah. True. You could have made a totally valid choice. And RNG
just started playing Planescape Tournament.
Yeah! By far the best story that's ever been in any game ever, so enjoy your time with that.
I'm trying.
I told you about that shit, it's the whip-in.
Yeah.
Did you get it off of GOG?
Yeah.
Okay.
Brendan gifted it to me on GOG.
After the whip-in!
What? Yeah. After a what?
The Whip-In.
You gave it to me like a year ago.
It's a bar down South Austin with the South Austin charm with South Asian food.
That's a lot of South.
That's its thing.
South.
Hey, what it used to be was just like a convenience store that served Indian food, and then it began to serve more Indian food and turned into like a whole restaurant, and then they added like an outdoor part with like a little stage.
Yep. It's a nice place. I like it.
Pretty cool place.
Must be food experience down there. It's been leveling up a lot.
How many hours do you put into that?
About one. I just wanted to kind of get the feel for it and see how much I liked it or whatever.
Have you died yet?
I did die one.
Is that awesome? And you're like, death doesn't matter.
Yeah. I plan on streaming it, so I just wanted to see.
Yeah!
That's a good
stream. Yeah.
Blind run.
That's awesome. I'll look forward to that.
Yeah, blind run.
Oh, man.
That's so exciting. There's so many different things you can do in that game.
Oh, no. What class are you?
That sandwich is not for you, Paul.
Yeah, you're just that
like,
guy.
Yeah, you're just that guy. Like, you can't... I guess you get class later.
So, I was a rogue, and the sass of that man as a rogue... is so, when you backstab, he says, like, left your back exposed, idiot. I just loved it.
Ah, the voiceover in that game is so great.
I was really excited too when like Morty.
Mm-hmm.
Morty.
Morty was like voiced by freaking Raphael and whatever, and I was like, dude, this is gonna be so awesome. And then like no other dialogue was voiced, you know, for like the whole time I played. I was like kind of super bummed, but I was like, man, what do you get?
Yeah, it's kind of those super important conversations than like the incidental stuff.
Yeah.
That's what really weirds me out about Pillars of Eternity, is we'll do a conversation, like the intro line will be voiced, and then the next line won't, and then the line after that will be.
That's really confusing.
I mean, I kind of see that it's one of those where, like, hey, we need another piece of dialogue here, we don't have time to VO it, but It just seems really inconsistent.
Still gotta play it.
But, Planescape Torment is great because I think that's the only game set in Sigil. Do you know if that's true?
I don't know of another off the top of my
head. Sigil is like the most fascinating place in all of the D&D universe, and at least in my opinion.
It's pretty cool.
The endless possibilities of weird shit happening.
Says the wild mage.
I'm almost hesitant to talk about it. I don't want to spoil crap.
talking about Sigil in general isn't really.
Well, yeah, not in general. I'm trying to remember what's in the game and what's not.
I'm enjoying how much like D&D it is. You know, like it's that. You know, like in modern games or whatever, so many things are left to. Like, you've got, like, 1,000 NPCs, and none of you can't interact with any of them.
Yeah.
But that one, like, every single thing you can, you know, every single person you can talk to.
So that reminds me, I've got this idea for a game that I'm never going to do, so are we on right now?
We are.
Shit.
I could mute it.
Never mind.
No,
just hope that there's
I'd
no lip readers.
Imagine, anyone ever played Bridge Commander?
Nope.
I've never even heard of Bridge Commander.
Bridge
is it like Wing Commander, just on ground?
No. Bridge Commander.
You're like
could
it
be? A toll booth? Like letting people through, raise the bridge.
It's
the bridge.
Papers, please.
All right, you guys are.
Papers,
are,
please,
I'm
Commander.
Not telling you any more about.
No,
this.
Come on.
I'm listening, Bridge Commander. There's got to be at least one person in chat that's like, "Oh my God, Bridge Commander!"
I think I've heard of it.
Bridge Commander was a Star Trek game.
Yeah.
Okay. There's no one saying that, but Sexy Nurse wants you to die.
So Bridge Commander was a Star Trek game in which you were basically like, you know...
Why isn't it called Star Trek Bridge Commander, then? Shouldn't it have Star Trek in the name?
It
probably should.
Come on!
You played basically as Picard, because everyone knows he was the best captain. And so you would be on the bridge, and you could fly your thing, your ship, and it was sort of like, you know, the naval combat, where you're flanking your ships and orienting your thing based on your shields and whatever.
Ooh.
But you could also direct your dudes to do it, too. So
Ooh.
If you wanted to, you could just sit there on the bridge with the holo screen in front of you and be like, all right, fire phasers and whatever. Okay, so that's Bridge Commander. What I would love to do is take an Oculus Rift... And make that game where you're actually that captain, and you're like sitting there, you know, looking around, doing shit, and then you could even get off the bridge and go talk to people. Like, you walk down and like go to sleep or something, and like talk to people.
I would love
to
go to sleep.
There's another game this is reminding me of, and I can't remember the game for the life. They play it at King's Isle, like, every time there's a game day. They like take over a whole room with it.
Oh, Artemis.
That's it, yeah.
We played that game has a lot of potential, but it's just not being met. I mean, we played it, but the scenarios weren't very interesting.
It's apparently got a lot more stuff to it now.
Okay.
Isn't there a number of FTL clones in the wing, too?
Boom. Yeah. I remember seeing that. It was multiplayer, I think.
Yeah.
I think it was supposed to be multiplayer, anyways.
There's a couple, I think, that are supposed to be in the works.
You know what? We ought to seriously try to do Artemis run for Fastfare.
Ooh.
Have you seen Convoy?
I've heard
that's like
really good.
Yeah, it's like an FTL clone, but like Mad Max style.
That's one of
mine.
Exactly. I was pretty interested. I was like, maybe I'll get that instead of
was
FTL.
Was it Convoy or?
I think it was Convoy. Yeah.
There's
Convoy.
Convoy.
I've been told about it.
There's a space game. I think Elite Dangerous.
Yes.
Something like that.
Yeah,
that's all about
that's
like shipping stuff.
Clone.
We played the demo with the Oculus Rift.
I've heard nothing but good things about that game.
That's more of a Wing Commander.
But I've heard that it is like you have to soak in hours to get the money to get the good stuff.
Yeah, and it's also like it's a 1-to-1 scale. So, like traveling through space takes as long as it takes to travel through space.
I was watching
12 years.
Mr. Boombody plays a lot of Elite Dangerous and walking into his stream. He's literally just jumping from point to point to point.
Gotcha.
So it's like there's lots of.
Isn't it them and like Star Citizen are the biggest competitors right now for that flight sim?
I don't think
space
anyone's really competing
space.
With Star Citizen. I mean, that's sort of saying, like, you know...
Well, for players still,
like,
you're always competing
for
players.
That's sort of like saying JCPenney competes with Walmart for anything.
I always confuse JCPenney with J. Byron's, even though J. Byron's hasn't been in business for 25 years.
I don't even know what J. Byron's is.
Well, there you go. You guys are too young. Back in my day.
How long ago
sounds like
that?
A Southern chain?
25 years ago.
Oh.
Back when I was
born. Is that
born.
Like a Florida thing? Or is it,
maybe.
Is it
I don't
national?
Know. It was another clothing outlet.
Nice.
It's not that interesting.
End of story.
Please tell me. I would like to know more. Where's the button to do?
Where's the button push when
I would like to know more?
You'd like to know more.
At a certain point, you're going to exhaust all my options, and I'm just going to repeat, go see Fury Road over and over again.
Is that a good movie?
It's so fucking good!
I've never seen Mad Max, and I don't like Mel Gibson.
That's fine. You don't have to have done either. I had never seen any of them. It has nothing to do with Mel Gibson whatsoever. It is probably the best action movie I've ever seen in my entire life.
Men on the internet have told me I shouldn't watch this movie.
Those guys are fucking horrible. It's so good.
I can't determine if that thing's like a satire.
It's not.
Like serious people.
It is not. They're completely serious.
Yeah, some is satire.
Terrible
but...
human beings.
Keyboards and monitors.
What happened last week?
Well, Marvin isn't seeing eye to eye with Antoria right now.
No.
Well, got ambushed. Actually, it was mostly just the ambush that happened last week. And the ambush nearly killed us all. Mm-hmm.
Except for Antoria.
Burning up,
and Zathus.
Funny how that happened.
Hey,
right?
I took damage. What are we
so
talking about?
We are on the path to the Halfling Forest. But on our way, we realized we were being followed. So we decided to stop and try and set up an ambush using some like pots of oil or jars of oil and try and maybe like light them on fire and catch them inside of it. But while trying to do that, we got attacked by some cats. Some crazy cats. They weren't very friendly. Some ligers, I think? Something like that?
Yeah.
And, yeah, they pretty much just tore you up, I think. Just ate this.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He had me pinned on the ground.
To be fair, I think both Marvin and the cat kind of tore up Zathus.
Yeah, that's true, too.
That was after. There were two Thunderwaves.
But that was a legitimate help, trying to help you.
Yeah, legitimately just stroking me, just like, just accept it.
Don't. I have a wound there.
You can yell, don't resist.
Yeah. So there was some friendly fire. Then the things that were following us turned out to be half giants, and
isn't friendly fire accidental? Just as a point of order. Never mind going.
Might be accidental, but I don't know about in some cases. But anyway, the giants caught up to us, half giants, and they beat the shit out of us pretty badly. There was a lot of fireballs that went off, including self-inflicted fireballs, and a lot of people got burned. And
our wizard resorted to doing the knife dance.
How does the knife dance go?
Yeah. Our mage.
Yeah, that's a good one.
Our mage is no longer. Our wizard is no longer a wizard. He's kind of relegated himself to zeroth level fighter. He's doing a little knife dance to distract people.
How does the knife dance go?
Move on.
And while we were fighting the half giants,
YouTube video. He knows the one I'm talking about.
The caravan we were supposed to protect started to run away, and I managed to get Zathus up because he'd gone unconscious. And instead of sticking around for the giants to beat the shit out of him, he decided that he was going to go chase after the caravan. And he tried to stop most of the caravan. In doing so, I think. Actually made things worse by rolling a 1 on a gem throw.
I'm not sure the die roll mattered for that one.
It made the gem explode everyone, including himself, I think. So that was cool.
But I was able to
or hot.
Dodge it.
That was hot.
Yeah.
And we lost some of the caravans. Some of them ran off into the forest, including the most important part,
Jungle.
The most important part of the caravan, though, ran off into the jungle, which was the stuff. The stuff ran off. We lost the two pack herd animal things. I forgot what they're called. Erdlu? Is that right?
Inixes.
Yeah.
Big lizards.
What were the Erdlu?
Erdlus are the reptilian chocobos.
Oh, the chocobos.
These are Inixes. They're lizards.
So the Inixes we lost.
I'll just get some real ones and put them on the table.
They had most of the goods and stuff for the caravan. So I think we managed to rescue all the people but two or three that ran off with the annexes,
yep. Something like that.
Yeah,
something like that.
And so that's where we're at now. We just
mostly hogtie them, burn them.
I tried to track them into the jungle with an eagle, but the eagle got eaten. So that's
it was a cheater eagle anyway.
That's probably good news for the annexes. So now we need to go into the jungle of death when we're all beaten up and we don't have many spells left. So
didn't we decide we're gonna do a rest?
We did a short rest.
Most people took a short rest. Someone went over to the stack of corpses to go neck.
Can we take a long rest?
Antoria's not around at the moment.
I mean,
over my back.
You're not that far away from where they're at.
Okay.
Unless you guys have pressing business with the corpses.
Do they have stuff?
They did not have very much stuff. Their stuff was back at their campsite.
Antoria picks up the bag that's been running around on the ground eating two of the corpses and wraps it back up and puts it back in his bag before going back over to the room.
How'd it get unwrapped?
I unwrapped it.
Oh. You were testing?
He tested it on one and then he was talking to Zathus and didn't pick it up in time and it got another one.
Yeah. I'm
hungry.
That did happen.
Alright, so you get to return to the rest of the group, and I believe a short rest was taking place, unless you've got...
Yeah, we took a short rest.
Alright.
I don't think we got the time.
Telek does
that.
Not.
Yeah. There's no time for that.
What do you mean there's no time for that?
Telek looks at his watch and says, look!
Three points to the jungle. All our supplies
are
headed that way.
All my friends are in danger!
We're dead.
Yeah, we need to get the pack animals. We need those.
Well,
a little too Mickey.
Yeah,
I
thought the same thing.
Need to do warm ups
before
the stream.
Antoria.
Yeah, I did it that last.
At this point, I'm about to get like room salt water. So if you guys think you can take care of any hostiles,
why does that work? It's so weird.
I'm good to go after a short rest, but I don't. I'm still gonna be mostly out of my healing spells. So
it'd be a lot easier to catch them now than it will be in another 7 hours.
Yeah, I think we really need to go after them right away.
As dense as that jungle is, I mean, we'll be lucky to find them now.
I stand a pretty good shot at finding them.
Are you sure?
I'm in good shape, at least.
Our
non-druid druid.
I'm sure there's something I could think of to help me find them.
That's good.
If only you could use your druid spells, but you've stopped since you've started becoming a lich.
Oh. I knew it.
The script is getting confused.
Bro, change seats. Your brains are swapped.
Yeah, I've got... Okay, bear form has good, like, tracking senses. It's got keen senses, keen smells.
You detect a picnic basket.
Well, I'm going after that. That's more important than everything else.
Hey, Marvin! I think we're gonna eat good tonight!
I don't think the ranger's gonna like that.
It's okay, rangers are no good in 5th edition.
Okay.
That's right. Oh!
Welcome to the stream, everybody.
Yeah. We're
give us your money.
Donate for more jokes like that.
Oh, boy.
And that's how
and
we never got a donation.
And we don't have any followers.
And the chat is empty.
Yeah. All
right,
just instant vacate.
Yeah.
All right, so.
So.
Instant chat wipe.
You insist on a long rest, or do you think... I mean, we could
I said, I'm as useful as Antoria right now.
Snap.
We could try and split up, but that's probably not a great idea. I think we need to chase him right away.
Marcus's shoulders.
We do have other reasons to be in a hurry, you know.
Well, what do you mean?
We have other reasons.
Antoria.
Yes.
Out of character. I forget if Marvin knows that you're not using spells.
I used some last battle, but then I stopped. I don't know if you noticed that. Cause you definitely threw some.
I mean, I knew that you weren't using spells.
Asked him if he knows about the guy we're looking for. He might know.
No, we haven't asked him. Anyway, sorry. You were saying.
What's the guy's name?
One at a time.
We're looking for Enola.
Nola.
Yeah.
The mindbender or something?
So I will inquire as to the reason why not using any of
your
spells.
I mean, maybe you are, but you're going the wrong direction.
Fireball
or
another
question.
I understand your need, but I no longer have control over the discipline required to preserve. You probably wanted to hear that too.
What? Do what now?
Do who? He said he doesn't have any self-control.
I do not have the self-control required for preservation.
So you can't... So that's why you can't cast spells.
If I were to cast spells, it would be at Athos's expense.
Listen.
Well, it's a good thing you stopped.
I think
sorry.
Well, we might as well fill you in. I'm sure you figured it out by now. Our friend here has an affliction.
What's
your name?
We're
he's got a terrible cold.
He has an affliction that we're trying to get cured, and we need to find someone who's beyond the forest as well.
I understand that we don't live in paradise here, but wizardly magic is no affliction, my friend.
He's not talking about wizardly magic.
I guess you really do have a cold. I'm sorry.
He has a rare curse.
Do we need to tell everyone
a curse
about him turning into a lich? Well, is that
a lich?
We need to shout.
Wait a minute! I want to shout this
from the roof. Antorio's turning into a lich. There.
Well, I was gonna try.
Actually, there is a little bit of an echo here in the mountain.
I was gonna try and skirt around it, but
that's not a pun.
Discretion was. Oh, that wasn't. You're right.
I'm so proud of you.
Yeah. I'm growing up. I know. It's unbearable. Anyway.
Until it kicks you off the mountain.
Our friend has an affliction, and we need to get him cured.
Oh, is it an affliction or a curse? You just said curse.
Either or both. It doesn't matter.
It matters very much.
Why?
Because maybe someone knows lesser or greater restoration. Now, come on! Try to work with me here!
I believe this
he actually
is some-
says this.
Okay. I believe this is something that a restoration cannot cure. It is something that we believe to be embedded deep within his mind and can only be cured by this man we're seeking, who has powerful abilities over the mind.
Indeed. We've been warned that tampering with it by other means may only make matters worse.
And how does that factor into our little arrangement?
We're going to escort you were there. We're still going to help you get to where you need to go. But where we need to go is supposedly beyond that. Do you guys remember the name?
I need to not write any
None of us
down.
Have the name of the guy.
You wrote a guy's name down. It's just not that
guy. Yeah, no, this is the one that what's-her-name gave us.
It starts with a G, I think, right? Romalia.
Orgo. It does. Orgo.
Orgo. Yes. We're seeking for Orgo.
Stupid party member remembers this shit.
By the power of Justin Bieber, anything is wrong.
No, Enola is the name of the druid in the Dragon's Bowl.
Yeah, that helped you find the foundry.
Protecting the foundry, that's right. Yeah.
Right.
That's or maybe protecting the foundry.
But I have.
Not,
I
he's
thought
not
we were
protecting.
Heading to Yurik, right?
What? Sorry?
No.
Yurik,
right? We're heading to the...
Yurik is the other direction.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
So, Antorio.
Yes?
While I don't understand your inability to control...
It's pretty easy to understand. It's caused by this damn curse.
I think that you need to, sometimes a little bit of sacrifice is in order to achieve a greater, what's the word I'm looking for?
Good?
Truth.
Lish. Truth. Squad of truth.
Let me get this
Squad
straight.
Of lich.
Mm-hmm. Squad of lich.
I'm proposing that I sacrifice Athos by bits and pieces to preserve our lives.
Yeah.
I think... let me approach this from a different angle.
I'm wholly against him using magic.
If you were to turn into a lich, imagine we all were to fall in battle, and you were the last one remaining, and you turned into a lich, the damage to Athos would be far, far more than a couple minor tricks would be.
I do not have the right to balance Athos's fate upon scales and decide.
I jumped ahead.
Yeah. Well, I'm not sure that a little bit is going to hurt Athos.
It's permanent.
Like I said, Athos is a pretty big place. Look
it's
at that
mostly a desert.
Look at that forest out there.
That's one of the last ones.
I agree with him. We need to preserve as much of Athos as we can at this point.
Right, but you understand...
Magic uses a defile have done enough damage.
We might not actually succeed. Does anyone else see this?
I do.
I certainly do, but the solution you propose...
It's just a little bit. I'm not asking
little.
For...
Even
I'm
the weakest
for,
of spells you can't control anymore.
I'm not asking for fireballs. I'm asking for a little bit of...
I had control fireballs. Over them until recently, but it began to slip during the most recent battle.
Maybe it was a fluke. Alright, how about we do this? We'll limit it to one spell per... We'll call this an encounter.
Make an insight check.
Okay.
Interior, your head is throbbing.
Yeah. He's definitely rubbing his head.
7.
Okay. Freya looks angry.
Well...
He's rubbing his head.
This isn't
going to
help.
Your insight helps with this.
Is the party agreed that he shouldn't be using his spells? What do you two think?
I mean, I'm not. I don't know much about this magic stuff, but if it's, he's usually right about these types of things, so I'm gonna trust his judgment on that.
Zathis, what do you think?
Well, I believe that keeping the party alive is important. I would do nothing to jeopardize Antoria's life and his belief in preserving this world.
There is one other thing we should consider, is that possibly using magic is even making you worse. It may not be helping the matter at all either. But
to be honest, I didn't detect that, but I don't know. Defiling alone is enough reason not to use it.
Well, what can we do to help him be useful in combat? Could giving him the crossbow help? You can use that, right?
What do you mean giving me the crossbow? I already...
Oh, you already have one.
You mean shooting him with a crossbow?
I thought we only had one.
Well, you can stand in front of me while I shoot over him. Like, at least protect me from some of this damage.
I stood blade in hand, shoulder to shoulder with these two after you fireballed yourself out of commission.
That was a little bit... That was not intended.
Luckily for you, patching you back together was intended.
Oh, that... I'm sorry.
I think we can all agree that without me, we would all been dead. That is an irrefutable fact, so I think it's time you give me a little respect. Antoria, you first. Did I or did I not single-handedly turn the tide of that battle?
I do not know.
It hurt us and it hurt them, but you did do quite a bit of damage to them as well.
Why are we wasting time with this?
Yes, we need to hurry on. We are wasting our time right now. For now, we should carry on as things are. We can discuss this after we found the Enixes that have all the important caravan supplies. Agreed?
You okay?
Bless you.
It'll be fine, I hope.
Okay.
Man, things aren't really real there.
That was my speech.
So. 10 free Tempe, everybody! Oh, Antoria sucks! The end.
So, a brief interlude.
Alright. Do, 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 do,
do, what? How did that happen?
The Monty Python.
Oh, jeez. I'm not cool enough. So we started here. That's Altrak.
Yes.
Then we went up this way.
Character, no.
You mean
wait,
the beginning?
We didn't. Oh, okay.
Very like months ago. Back before the dawn of webcams.
Yeah.
We did a little bit of exploring there, and we chased Slither up this way. Then Slither caught you guys and went off.
We like to not talk about that part.
No, it was great. It was very unexpected.
Yeah. Got robbed of all our goodies.
Yeah, so then we went to the Mausoleum of Shram. And
got the golden crown. And I almost died.
Lots of stuff happened. And then we wandered into the Ringing Mountains, and we found the Arakakra and the Knolls, and that ooze. Then we descended down into Tyre.
Yeah. I almost forgot about that. That was probably the closest we came to wiping.
Did some fire, and then you guys went this way, and now you're like right about here.
Mm-hmm. About that.
Yeah.
It's a huge forest.
It's pretty big.
Jungle.
Forest.
They don't know the difference. There's not that much green stuff. Just green, they're impressed.
Most people don't go there, so they don't know things.
So, for now, I think I can track the Enixes.
That's an unflattering angle.
What are you
it was just like staring like right up at that.
Oh. Nice.
Yeah.
Soul patch cam. Uh-huh.
So I believe myself able to track the
Enixes. I don't have more chins
there
anymore.
But I'll have to do it in bear form. So I won't be able to communicate with you guys really much after we get started on our journey. So
can you still do that thing with the mind?
Which
where you talk to
No, that's a spell.
Can you do the thing where you put
the thing in the thing?
Alarm on the ground?
That is a spell. What did you think I was setting up tripwires or something?
I thought so.
My last D&D.
I failed my rolls most of those times to see if you were casting spells or not.
Alright, so you're telling me you literally.
I have a crossbow and a dagger.
And a dagger.
That's it.
Well,
are you
maybe you can tell jokes to the monster because I never heard such a joke as you.
Are you able to use a scimitar? I have one I can loan you.
I've got a plus one bone longsword here.
A sling.
I don't know if it would have been noticeable, but the crossbow he was using looked like a masterwork, which he hadn't had up until this point.
Okay.
I'm as well equipped as I probably could be, but thank you.
Alright.
Have we already rested, or is this pre-rest?
This is
post. Do we have another hour? Of...
We had a short rest.
This is post-rest. I think we said we were
lining
resting.
Up the rest.
Right. We said we were resting.
Sure, that sounds good.
At the end of last session.
Sure.
Now we're starting to track the
Yeah,
animals.
So I'm going to go to bear form, and I'm going to attempt to use my keen senses and smell to track the annexes.
Ventoria will try to investigate to the same purpose.
Okay.
To make a survival check.
Natural one, yeah.
You appear to be in a mountain of some kind.
I'm supposed to get an advantage on smell-based perception checks.
Excellent.
So.
Tanks are smelly. Or enixes or which are...
Natural 20.
Whoa!
So that's
they
like,
show up on your mini-map.
Yeah. So that's a 26.
With a distance indicator.
Boink, boink, boink.
Perfect. So I'll start heading in the direction of where the Enix is.
Excellent. You start doing that Looney Tunes thing where your nose is just flat on the ground.
It's like moving along.
How long does bear form last? Like 2 hours?
Yeah, cool. 2 hours right now.
Okay.
3 hours next level.
So that might actually like matter for what we're doing.
True. Yeah. So you may want to keep track of time. I've got 2 hours.
All right. All
right. Ventoria's staying with you nearby. All
right.
Okay.
I'm staying with Ventoria.
You guys descend into the depths of the forest ridge.
And the caravan, I hope, is staying really close to us.
Yes, they're clustered behind, weapons clutched at the ready. They are not eager for more adventure, but the forest awaits.
Probably bring up the rear guard, too.
We should probably last.
Yeah, what's your marching order here?
I gotta be in front, so...
We should probably tie all the Eric...
Because I'm leading.
...the Terrans together. So anyway, they can't...
Hey, yeah, right. Tie them with a rope like they're slaves. they just had that experience.
Over well.
So who wants
just
to go
around the waist, not around the neck?
Who wants to be by the bear?
I'll be next to the bear.
Okay.
I can bring up the rear.
All right. You two, do you care?
I'll be up front. I might still be able.
Maybe
to
the flanks
tracking.
Of the caravan.
I'll stay up front.
You're walking next to me.
Yep.
That's a
bull. Is Aethys?
I'm keeping an eye on Antoria and Marvin. So
are you
walking
in front of me,
middle,
or behind me, or next to me?
There you go. All right. So that's our marching order.
Okay, so you guys descend into the forest. Everyone give me a survival check.
Ooh. 21.
Oh, survival goes west.
Pretty good. Oh, no.
17.
19.
2.
12.
21,
sorry. And we've got Barrett up front, and you got a 19?
Yes.
Cool. And who is in the very... Oh, it's you. Okay. Good. You've come across a tripwire of some kind.
Ooh.
It's made out of a vine. It seems to be stretched between two.
Is he a character?
No, sorry.
Oh,
no, sorry.
I'm so confused.
No, because I just said...
Yeah, your character's name is Tripwire.
Well, my old one was. I hope we do that campaign. Not with you guys, my old group. I mean, I like playing with you guys.
I'm going to stop, let out a bear grunt. Point at the wire, which I can do, I think.
Am I aware of this as well?
You
and
are
hold up
not,
the other paw,
no,
I guess.
It's only
I guess a bear can do that.
Okay.
No.
Standing on two legs?
Do I see it now that he's pointing it out?
Yes.
Alright, Victoria says some sort of tripwire up here. Sounds like your department's Aethys.
I come forward and investigate.
Sure.
That's 10. Thirteen.
The animals miss it anyway.
They may not have necessarily come this direct path. I'm just tracking them. They, for
you
instance, could have wandered off. And
like it's taut. It's perfectly taut, but you can't quite see like a knot or something like that.
Okay. I feel reasonably confident that I could disarm it.
Looks pretty simple. I mean, it's just made of jungle rope.
All right. I'm gonna attempt.
What we call a vine.
Hold on there. Notice that you're getting dangerously close. While I respect your craft and your trade, this is something we could... From a distance, maybe, trip. I would just hate for you to mess up and get yourself injured. I mean, I just don't see any unnecessary risk.
He says unconvincingly.
Yeah, really.
I would really hate to see you injured.
Thunder waving me earlier that day.
Right, twice on the thunder wave.
Yeah. Well, see, he doesn't want to see other things injure you.
Yeah.
He wants to be the one injured.
That's true.
You.
Just make sure you're full of hit points.
I mean, you do what you will. I'll just food for thought.
Xanthus ignores him and goes about trying to disarm.
Sounds good.
The trap. See, is that anything in particular, or is it just a straight, plus, is it a dex mod, or what? I mean, what would disarm?
I thought there was.
Because I have
the thiefy thing.
I have thieves' tools, but that's more for like unlocking things. I don't know about.
It would probably include stuff for dealing with tripwires and whatnot.
Sleight of hand?
Yeah, there's sleight of hand, but
I mean, it's a trap. It's a roll on your tool skill.
I mean, I'm
yeah,
assuming you're
trap,
trying to
it's
cut,
a trap check.
Just cut the wire,
it's a
right?
Trap check.
Yeah, it's plus three. It's your proficiency plus the relevant stat.
Okay, which I'm guessing is dexterity.
It's probably dex, yeah, or it could be. It's up to be man.
It's dex plus proficiency mod.
Yeah.
Okay, so it's plus 7.
Plus any bonuses you have to your toolkit.
Just proficiency.
All right.
So.
Good luck.
18.
18?
Yeah.
The vine slips from your grasp and wraps around your wrist as though it was a tendril or a snake or something like that. It yanks you bodily up into the air. You're dangling from the tree.
Oh, for fuck's sake! No one listens to me!
I shout down, I'm fine. I pull out my dagger and try and cut myself free. How
sure.
High up in the tree am I?
You're about 10 feet up.
Yeah,
they can see you pretty clearly.
Yeah, I try and cut myself free.
Okay. Next to you on the side of the tree's mouth basically opens up. Yeah, this tree has a mouth, by the way. The mouth goes.
I expedite trying to cut through the trying to cut through the vine.
Sure. Give me an attack roll.
Roll one.
I guess I could ask if there's a roll to catch him, but
any mods to this?
It's just an attack roll.
An attack roll.
Okay.
Oh. 4.
Well.
Because I'm, I mean.
Yeah.
Most attack rolls you add.
You add your
proficiency. And dex mod.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Like that, so. That's why I was asking if there's any modifiers.
Well, yeah.
So
whatever you
roll.
Get for an attack roll.
Okay.
Dagger.
So.
Or whatever it is that you're using.
11, and I'm using my dagger, which.
Short bow.
Doesn't give me any.
Dagger bow.
So, 11.
As a matter of fact, you flail at it, but you're not able to land a solid cut. The vine begins to swing you back.
All
right. A little bit closer to the mouth.
Try something?
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay. I am going to use
yeah.
Tides of Chaos.
Okay.
To firebolt the. Is the vine something that's thick enough I feel like I could hit, or is it better off?
It's pretty skinny,
uh-huh.
And it's mostly on the other side of Xanthus at this point.
Okay.
Like, he's, like, straight up.
I see. I guess I'll just firebolt, then, the tree.
Okay.
And I will use my Tides of Chaos to get advantage on that.
Are we doing rounds at this point, or...
I keep track. If anyone else wants to try something, you're welcome.
I want to keep trying to.
Well, let's see what happens with Marvin.
Okay.
24.
24
yeah.
To hit.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's gonna hit.
That might have hit the vine. That's 15 fire damage, and I lose my Tides of Chaos.
The whole tree starts shaking. Now you're sort of swinging back and forth, no longer towards the tree itself, just sort of.
Okay. I'm going to continue to try and cut the.
Okay.
Toria's glaring at his crossbow in frustration, looking at the tree.
Firebolt! You want to save your friend? Now's the time to sacrifice yourself!
25?
25! That'll absolutely hit. Give me some damage.
Damage with my dagger is a 1d4 plus 4. Five.
Five?
You manage to just barely sever the vine. You come plummeting to the ground.
All right.
You take 1 point of falling damage.
Barry's just like, burr, burr, burr.
Half I think that you can, yes.
Zero.
Nice. All right. Just roll to a stop. Pretty good.
I meant to do that.
The tree is still shaking angrily.
I stare at Marvin and I said, if you wouldn't have distracted me, this would never have happened.
Barrett's going to
roar. My concentration.
Roar out loud and then start moving forward again past the tree.
I will firebolt again whenever
sure.
You will allow it.
Absolutely.
All right. I will aim for the tree. Crit.
Oh! Oh,
tree.
Time to set this jungle on fire.
12,
24. 24? It is suitably ablaze.
We somehow scorching that thing, the squad of truth.
It's like, it's like Don't Starve.
We actually write our name in the truth.
How serious is the danger of it spreading look?
There's trees everywhere.
Yeah, pretty serious?
Absolutely.
Tori is glaring at the tree. It's like, what?
Is Barret still moving? Like, you still gone,
yeah,
right?
You
still gone.
The tree yet?
No, Barret's gonna...
He said he walked past the tree.
I don't think Barret can put out the fire.
When you allow it, I'll throw another fireball. I mean, you guys are just standing there. I'm
It sounds like most people are standing
there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Staring at it.
I don't.
He looks like he wants to do something, but can't make up his mind what.
Yeah, I mean, what are we gonna do?
Barrett's gonna rush forward to try and knock the tree over.
It's okay. Sure.
Just attack it, I guess.
Is this a sapling?
Yeah, wait,
it is
tree.
Not. No.
Okay.
But I'm not gonna hit it. I got.
You missed a tree.
You missed the tree.
I rolled a two.
You missed
the
tree.
Sure, I missed the tree.
Face first into the tree.
Yeah. Does the seven hits? Fire threw me off.
Now bears can actually climb trees.
Yep. It's true.
The tree is on fire.
Especially if it's on fire.
Marcus will take a hack at the tree.
There we go.
Okay. With your greatsword, I'm guessing?
My greatsword.
Okay.
19.
19 will hit.
16 damage.
Okay. You take a good chunk out of part of the base. Quick guess leads you to think that maybe like 300 more strikes might get you halfway through the trunk.
We're wasting time.
Yeah, right. I say we
Barrett's
keep
going. Barrett's gonna move on. There's nothing you can
the
do
the tree
about
seems
this.
To like waft down at you and like snaps its jaws, but it doesn't come anywhere close to actually connecting with you.
Can I roll perception to see if the
distance.
Tree is the base is moving? As it seems stationary,
is
or
it rooted?
Can I see it like move its feet?
It's well, trees don't have feet.
Roots.
Its roots
thanks,
seem
thanks, you know,
in place.
It's a
yeah.
Tree.
Immobile.
Is it immobile?
It's stuck in place at the ground, yes. It's just sort of wobbling like a...
like you're waving arm inflatable.
Yeah,
guys.
Yeah, one of those guys.
Well, as long as our teammates are there, I'd like to throw another fireball.
Okay.
Fireball.
You can give me a perception check if you like.
Oh, yes, I will do a perception check on that.
Sure.
4.
Mm. Mm-hmm. It's getting hot. It's surprisingly humid here, by the way. You're in a forest. Most of you haven't been in a forest before. It's oppressively soggy.
12.
12 to hit?
Mm-hmm.
That will hit.
10 fire damage?
10 fire damage.
Barret sees a futility in this, and he's going to move along.
Yeah.
Everyone else can give me a perception check if you like.
Okay.
Is it a smell-based perception
it
check?
It is not.
12.
Is it a sight-based perception check?
Yes.
Natural 1! Is there a fumble chart for perception checks?
No.
Oh, it wasn't an intro.
Your eye falls out.
Yeah. It's okay,
18.
I'll get it back once I shift
18?
Back.
Yeah. Anyone else get close 17. To
17? 12.
Zathus and Marcus, you can see that the Desperate attacks of whatever this creature is seem to have lit the adjacent trees on fire.
Are they screaming as well?
No.
Okay.
Yeah, as much as I figured was going to happen. We should probably get moving.
Well, now that we've set one of the last forests on fire, maybe we should get going.
We wouldn't be the squad
Marcus,
if we didn't leave fire.
Are you
fire.
Still next to the tree?
No, I backed off after it tried to bite me.
Oh, okay. So everyone is like away now?
Yeah.
Alright, then we can go.
Yeah, Barrett's gonna move along. There's not much he can do about this. He'd
nope.
want
yeah.
to do something.
I will kind of like...
We're losing the Enixes.
For what?
You were so right!
For what? Lighting the tree on fire? Lighting the forest on fire? I had this. You saw me. You did nothing.
Talek catches up with the rest of you. Hey, what was all that? What is that fire? What's going on here?
You're not you see the talking, you see the screaming and moving tree in the fire, and the first thing you ask about is the fire? Well,
I've been here before, Sonny. I've seen a lot of creatures. I've seen a lot of plants too. Those
this
are different.
One's apparently spontaneously combusting.
Oh, I'm all for self-defense, but. The Earth Mother wouldn't like it if you're just burning down huge sections of the forest.
Well, I don't have any water.
Any spare water we had is ahead of us.
Water for... extra water for dispensing upon this tree.
Well, thank you for the clarification.
The abundance of water that we would need is nowhere.
Well, if we're lucky, perhaps a rainstorm will take it out.
Does it... Is it really on fire? Like,
oh, absolutely.
Blazing?
Yeah.
Like, it's going to catch on.
Like,
okay.
You
critted.
Like Smokey the Bear is like,
you crit pretty
right
good.
I did. Yeah. Alright, yeah, we better get out of here. Before someone notices.
Antoria, give me an insight check.
Natural 20.
He's actually not kidding at all. He seems pretty, like.
Agitated?
No, on the up and up about the idea of maybe a rainstorm will just take it out.
Okay. Fair enough.
It's super humid here.
Fair enough.
It's like all the moisture that isn't anywhere else in Athos is here.
So we're like,
you have a rainstorm in Athos. It's like, what are you kidding?
So we're like walking underwater.
Fair enough.
You're in the Florida of the Dark Sun universe.
we're in
Florida. It's a terrible place.
Yeah. A man bursts America's in weighing. And clearly on methamphetamine and wearing a mask of sharp mercury. Florida man, what are you
Florida
doing
man.
Here?
Oh man!
Right.
He gets around.
Moving on with tracking, leaving the burning forest behind.
Indeed,
yes.
Barrett, give me another. Barrett, give me a survival check.
Natural 20.
If you want to give me, well,
investigation. Well, you got a natural 20.
Yeah,
I might see it too. Maybe I got a 20 total.
Well, you see a forest, but he smells the Enixes.
Yeah.
After about another hour of carefully treading through the thick foliage and watching for screaming trees in there. Predatory vines, you come across a small clearing. Centered in the clearing is a enormous clay pot of some kind, dangling which over appears to be the remaining Terrans from your party. On one side of the clearing are the Enixes that you have so recently lost, and surrounding the enormous pot are
a bunch of friendly individuals.
A bunch of
Ewoks.
Friendly Ewoks.
Oh, like they're
Ewok
in a, like they're in a soup.
They're over.
Like they
soup.
Might be dipped into a soup.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay.
As a matter of fact, let me see if I have some sort of a
map.
Of a map.
Visual aid.
A combat aid.
Thanks for your help.
There's a couple of
I could find it on
map paper. Markers down near John and Herbie. If you would line those
that
corners up
page
there.
Is there, looking up into the sky, do we see huge plumes of smoke, or did it not appear to?
You can't really see the sky from where you're at.
Oh.
In fact, this clearing is the first of the sky that you've seen in maybe an hour and a half.
It's quite jungly. Trees everywhere.
Need to unmute. Roam.
Oh, I see what's about to happen.
Nice!
Get
just
it?
Chrono Trigger?
It is.
Yeah.
I press X.
All right. Well, seeing our friends in danger, the rest
are they
of the...
like being, are they like dead and being cooked, or like
they're like tied
they're...
to a spit
okay, so
over
dead,
the stew?
Yeah.
The stew okay. appears. There's a fire on the logs, not you know a fire of the size that you've seen in the past hour or so. Enough that it's the pot seems to be bubbling.
Barrett's gonna charge the spit if he can, if there's enough room to do so.
Now you very recently missed a tree. Are you sure that this is the course of action that you want to take? That gave you pause, didn't it?
How many people?
Yes, because it's what I said I'm doing.
Oh.
I see friends in danger, and I'm going to try and help them.
Thank you.
How many people are actually there?
There are seven.
Oh my god.
What? I think there's seven.
Yeah, I'm going to try and push this spit off of the pot.
Okay.
If
give
I can
me
that.
A... I guess you're making it a charge attack, right?
Yeah, yeah.
So give me a charge.
What die do I trust? None of them is the answer.
I recommend a d20.
D100.
Oh, natural 20.
What?
All right. My die are doing pretty good today.
Why don't you describe for us your...
Killing
balls. Of killing all seven Arakakra. Or, not Arakakra.
Well, so you're charging in and you're...
I'm charging and I'm attempting to basically use my weight to push the spit out of the way of the pot.
That sounds perfect. You knock it over in such a way that it perfectly collapses on the other side.
Alright.
So this thing was not hot?
Oh,
it was.
The spit was not hot. The pot is very hot.
I'm not knocking the pot over. They're on the. I imagine they're on like a spit that's tied like above it. And if I knock over like the supports.
That's not a Conan reenactment yet.
Yeah.
Not yet.
So. Now I'm gonna get stabbed by a bunch of halflings.
Good news, there's only six of them.
Oh, okay.
Oh.
For now.
Well, yeah, I mean, they live in the forest. So, these guys are saved.
And
if you could arrange those three on the other side in similar configuration.
Roar after knocking it over.
Why doesn't everyone give me an initiative check?
This die is pretty good. No, it's not. That's pretty all right.
Yeah. Nice. I got a 10.
Yeah.
So when we win, if I don't hear frog song.
That's not the victory music.
It's gotta be.
Why wouldn't it be the victory music?
Huh?
Oh, because there's no victory music.
It's
no, wait, there is
Lucas
victory music.
Theme, isn't it?
No, that's the victory music in Chrono Cross. There is victory music,
no,
but it doesn't get used very often.
Frog's song is basically the victory music.
Does anyone want a drink?
I'll get a beer.
I'm good.
Thanks.
Okay.
Got a 12.
12? An auspicious number.
You got my 10.
Twice the number.
10?
Yeah, I got
an auspicious number.
Yes.
Marcus?
Also 10.
10?
With a 2 dex mod? Mm-hmm.
Harvey, what's his?
My dex mod?
No, his.
Oh, Bill's?
He's in bear form. His dex mod is a 0.
0. Ah. Say this.
7.
7?
17.
17? An auspicious number, Marvin.
21.
21? I barely had to do anything.
Hold on.
Wait. This might get old pretty fast.
No,
not.
It's gonna
be
awesome. I played an entire game with this music.
What are you talking about? Beat it several times each, probably.
Yeah. I've bought Chrono Trigger more often than any other video game. I bought it for every platform that comes out, regardless.
I've bought it at least 3 times.
Regardless of whether I play it or not, I always buy it.
I've done it with KOTOR. I've bought it on every platform.
Did you buy it on the iPad?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
I got it on the iPad, the iPhone.
How
was that?
All the halflings are first anyway, jeez.
Yeah,
PC.
Yeah, they are
Xbox
pretty spry.
Fast all the critters.
How was it
all right, so,
It's really good.
Really? Yeah.
Those two that are closest to me on Bill's side are going to approach and stab at you with a... some mean-looking spears. One is going to connect.
Oh, I'm sure they both do.
What is your...
12?
Oh, actually, as a matter of fact, they do.
Yep.
That's wonderful. Congratulations, in a way.
I don't have any armor. Just bare fat.
That's right. That's right.
Bare fat.
There you are. One connects for 7 damage, okay. And another for 13.
All right, damn, 20 damage. Pretty good.
Good for a small fry.
Yeah.
This one is going to loop back around here and swing a sling, tossing a rock in your direction. It flies over your head.
All
right. And then these other guys, let's see, what do we got?
Sorry.
Need one of those, like...
Oh, one of those pushers?
Or a secretary, I was going to say, but... Okay, this guy touches his hand to this one's forehead, and his skin seems to turn into the bark of a tree.
Oh, good.
Can I roll perception?
I know that spell.
Sure.
Or are we saying that I noticed that?
I'm saying that anyone looking into the... I mean, there's not enough chaos going on just yet.
Because I can cast that.
Looked like bark skin.
It looked like bark skin.
It wasn't exactly a sneaky spell.
It wasn't, no. He doesn't seem to have any reservations about disguising his spellcasting.
No, he's going
to
be our dude.
And that one will circle around and also swing his sling. And again, flies right over your head.
Good.
Marvin!
I will use Scorching Ray, I believe that one's called.
Yeah.
Scorching
yeah.
Ray, and I want to target this guy here.
Barky?
The guy that cast the spell.
Okay, ask for a Barky. Got it.
Let me double check that I'm within range. I thought
it's pretty long, I think.
Yeah, that's what I think, too.
I think you've got the entire piece of paper covered.
120 feet, yeah.
You're good.
Damn. It's a long range, Ray.
Bows have huge range, too. I mean, it's not out of line for
bows have a penalty at a certain range, though.
Not at 120.
Long bows are even more than that. That's just a short bow.
Wow. crit fail. 11. 13.
Wow.
Any of those hit?
No, I'm sorry.
Alright, well, at least do you want me to do wild magic? Also, I crit fail. Do you want me to do anything with that?
Let's do the crit fail first, and then let's roll some wild magic to get the party started. Except we're going to start with the crit fail.
12.
12! Power Surge! That spell is unavailable to you for the next 1d4 rounds.
I'm out of spells anyway after that.
Yeah!
1d4!
Do you want me to do Wild Magic?
Yes.
There's my thing.
D10?
No, I'm looking. Yeah, oh, here
it's
we
right
are.
Right
there. Got it. 9-9! What is this?
I think we've gotten that one.
Do you get all your spells
nice.
Back?
Yeah, well, I regain all my expended sorcery points.
That's a cost spell.
So that actually. I will need to track this now. So 1d4, I can't use Scorching Ray. Ugh.
Three turns.
And as a bonus action, I will... Yes!
That's the Marvin theme for now.
As a bonus action, I will spend... some amount of sorcery points to recharge a level 1 spell.
Cool.
I think it's only...
Zathus.
I think it's 2, but I'll double check that.
Cheapy.
Let's see. This is all just like... trees, right?
Yeah, where it's just thick foliage.
We can freely move in here.
No, actually, it's difficult terrain.
It's difficult terrain.
Yeah, you guys are moving pretty slowly.
10, 20, 30. I can see into this area, though. I can see into the clearing from here.
You can, yes.
Okay. Take a shot at the shaman-looking guy or whatever.
His headache seems to be getting noticeably worse.
Actually, do you mind if I change that to just recharge one level 3
That's
spell?
Fine. Yeah.
13?
13 will not hit.
Okay. Then I do nothing further.
Okay. Antoria.
Antoria seems to be having a pretty major headache, but he shakes it off. And then, with an odd glare in his eyes, he points at the caster. And I'm using insight on this. Double natural one. Holy
Wait,
you're using insight?
No, this was a spell, but it's gonna
fail.
Holy
shit, hardly. That's amazing!
Well, it was one of those spells.
Okay.
It was one of what spells?
Something.
alright.
A greenish yellow beam flies way off as a spell fumble happens.
Oh, good.
Fumble result is
flies up into the air.
18.
18?
Distracted.
Well, yeah,
you have to
is.
Spend your bonus action refocusing.
All right. However, this spell oddly hits even on a miss. So something will happen that goes way off, and then at the last moment arcs back around and hits anyway.
All right.
Dealing.
It's like a really, really risky scorched earth shot.
Like that. I'm missing one plinky die. There we go. Sure. 3, 4, 8, 10.
Unused music?
Yep.
Yep.
Unused boss battle.
How about that?
11. He takes 5 points of acid damage as the acid eats into him slightly.
It seems.
Does that defile? Is there some defiling going on?
Oddly enough, no.
Wouldn't you like to know?
I would, actually.
Well, I guess you can check.
Someone's awfully interested in defiling.
Yeah.
Something a lich would say.
Lich bear.
Fucking.
Should I roll for that?
You can give me some perception. Okay. You're kind of in the thick
also,
of it, though.
That's
so
true.
You're gonna
where
have
are the guys that have spilled out?
I'm sorry?
Where are the guys that have spilled out?
They are on the other side of the pot over here.
So I will say that they are all designated by this square or these four squares?
Those four squares.
Okay.
Even with disadvantage, I still got a 15.
15? You notice that someone's doing a little bit of spell cast.
Okay.
Yeah.
Is it defiling at all, though? Could I tell that?
You can't see the ground or anything like that.
What about me? Oh, I got a 1. Did I notice that?
No. You didn't even see it happen.
No.
These are
you appear to be
friendlies?
In a forest of some kind. Those are the Inixes with your packs.
Tori's looking at his hand.
Those
like
are Inixes.
And Tori looks at his hand like he's not sure what happened. That's the end of his turn.
Okay. Marcus.
This is all...
Forest. Difficult terrain.
Difficult terrain until we get in here?
Yes. Okay.
Then I will double move.
I guess I should ask. Antoria casts a spell. There's no defiling in his immediate area, right?
56.
I mean, it's nice and green. Or it was nice and green.
He doesn't notice any, no.
Okay.
Alright, yeah. So I've double moved here and emerged from the shrubbery of the forest.
It's funny, Barrett doesn't care as much about you casting spells as he does you defiling.
Well, funny enough.
Barrett, it's your turn.
Corey is in the same boat usually, but.
Alright, I will slash and bite at the halfling right next to me, this one, I guess.
Okay.
Light blue will be claws. Natural 1.
Yeah! Oh,
wow. Seems to be the pattern.
So many failures.
Does a.
More like squad of.
Double 1.
14.
Double one.
Does a 14 hit? Though?
It doesn't.
Okay. So then I miss, and then I fumble. For my fumble, that's on the claws. Nine.
Nine? You fall prone. You swing wildly and fall to your nose.
I guess I have a bonus, like it's our movement still, so I'll just stand back up. And then roar at him again.
Okay.
As intimidating as that could be, I just fall over and then...
Yes, indeed. Alright, so the shaman-looking guy mumbles to himself and touches his hand to his own forehead, and then nimbly leaps over the entire cauldron to the other side.
This one?
Yes.
Where do you want to go?
Over near the Terran.
Oh.
This, wait.
Terran.
Oh.
There you go.
Okay. Yeah. Those two halflings near Barrett are going to take some stabs.
Okay.
One will hit. You take... Yeah.
Yeah.
11 points of spear damage.
I take, yeah, damage.
Right to your...
Bear snout.
Bear butt.
Yeah, right in the butt.
This one over near the Inixes swings his sling in Marcus's general direction. That will crit.
Ooh.
I'll roll twice. You take 13 points of stone damage right to your forehead.
Brink. You're being stoned.
Ow.
Then these other two halflings on the far side of the pot will circle around to the other side of Barrett and also jab with their spears.
These guys?
Yep.
Lovely. I'm not going to be a bear for long.
One hits.
All right.
You take 12.
Ooh, still a bear. That's one bloody looking bear, though.
Marvin.
I'm going to scream out, yeah!
They're all just circling.
Watch and learn! And fireball. Fireball time.
Blurn ball?
Oh boy.
Actually, yeah, let me get the plate.
Of course.
Need the dinner plate.
Watch and learn, Antoria.
Yeah.
So I'm going for here.
Oh, nice.
I'm not. I don't know if you're considering
this.
Like, are
you're blowing up
can
a culture.
Can I? I guess the question is, am I going to hook this guy, or are we considering this sort of a solid wall?
Well, it goes around corners, so you're okay. Good.
All right.
Yeah. So you can hit exactly the targets you want.
Including the bear.
Yes.
Oh, God. You rolled...
I am not a bear anymore.
You rolled average.
I guarantee
yeah,
it.
Yeah, nothing too great. Actually, those fives are nice.
Yeah. Some fives and some twos. It kind
of
works
oh,
out.
Oh, wait, a lot of fives.
Yeah, oh, maybe there were a lot of fives. We blew up our bear.
Yeah.
32 dex is 16 for half.
Die be good to me.
So I've got five rolls to make, is that right?
You passed,
good,
probably.
Yeah.
Well, you have no dex bonus.
I do as a bear.
You do?
I do not as a bear.
16
is exactly what you needed there, you're good. Right.
And what is it that I need to
16
make?
16 on dex.
16.
Well, they are
no, I do, actually.
So one of them doesn't make it. We'll
oh,
say the park's got
saves,
one.
Yeah.
And how much do we take?
32 or 16? 30,
yeah.
And the concentration check might be in order. For
so I pass the save, but I am not a bear anymore.
Alright.
And would you like me to roll for wild magic?
Hell yeah.
17 you said? So 6
no.
Damage.
Can I get inspiration for that?
No, 32 or 16 damage.
For attacking party members? Oh,
yeah,
right.
Absolutely.
Actually, I already had one. So
oh, yeah, I think all of you do.
Yeah,
I used it to double fumble.
No?
Maybe I
oh,
just...
you said you were using insight. I didn't know what you were
talking
about.
Oh, sorry. I always... Yeah, inspiration. Yeah.
Maybe I've inspired Antoria with my display of power and blood-curdling scream.
Mm-hmm. You are pretty good at screaming. So the barkskin guy actually goes up in a ball of flame.
And I go, yeah!
Did some shades
again.
Drop down on your head? And...
I don't have sunglasses in my inventory.
Only.
We need to fix that.
Actually, Zathus has some.
Yep.
Yes.
Speaking of Zathus.
Good. Zathus. Sunglasses on.
No, I'm not a bear anymore.
Oh.
Sorry. I am definitely not a bear. I'm a slightly charred human.
What's up?
Alright, moving. 10, 20, 30. And double move. Is this out of? Is this technically out?
Yes, that's
terrain?
Out.
Okay.
I hastily scribbled.
15, 20, 25, 30. Okay. That's it, right? Yeah.
Yeah. If you
just
move,
double
move.
Double
move.
Okay. Cool. Etoria.
All right.
Gonna lich out some more.
A little bit. Let's see how it works. Emporia moves over to here. Closes his eyes and begins to gesture. A red and black orb appears about right here and then explodes in a burst of force covering these two guys. DC 15 con save.
I'm gonna do
perception.
I think one of those guys died.
I crit on
the
perception.
Wait, these guys died?
One of them died.
The
guy that was.
The barkskin was burst into flames.
Oh, the guy with barkskin.
I thought he just burst into flames. I
didn't
know. No, he went up in a ball of flame.
Okay.
I thought you meant the guy who cast it. My apologies.
No, no.
Let me rewind that slightly.
Yeah, did you want to do something different as a consequence of the way that reality works?
Oh, this is difficult terrain?
Yeah,
yes, it is.
Ah, I see. Well, then, in that case, I can get it this way, I think.
Okay.
Same idea.
Against two of the spear
well,
guys.
Explode, so, DC 15 con save.
Against two of my guys?
These two.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
The ones I miss.
They're both gonna fail pretty bad.
Alright, and they take... Oh, Jesus. Shitty rolls. That's a little better. 14 thunder damage.
Oh, man.
And they get shoved back 10 feet.
Thunder damage?
Both of them go flying into the pot.
So I might crit on my perception, and from behind you, you hear, yeah!
Wrong a fool again!
Victoria turns back briefly at your scream. His eyes are solid black, but they go back to normal almost an instant.
Whoa, later. It's so cool.
I rolled a 9. Did I see any of that?
He looks pretty confused.
You saw him go flying, but nothing else.
Okay.
He seems a little confused to see himself in his present location, but he doesn't move back because he's out of movement.
Sounds good.
He's done.
Marcus?
Well.
What color are your eyes?
Yeah, yeah, what color are your eyes? Come on. What's on your character sheet?
Half giant.
Yep.
it's half giant. Eyes.
There's just two little half giants.
15. I'm going for the sling guy.
Okay.
I will attack twice, at least. Probably just twice. There's a crit.
Nice.
Yeah, probably just and once.
You crit,
actually,
you crit way too much.
Second is almost
twice as often as normal.
Yeah.
When he attacks twice,
that he has that 19.
Well, that's what I mean. He has the 19, 20, right. And he gets two attacks. I mean, yeah. Kind of a
probabilities are pretty high.
12 plus 14, 26 plus 11, 37 damage.
Damn. 37 damage. Describe for me how you kill this little guy.
I just slice him horizontally in half.
All right, so you get down on both knees.
Yeah. So you drop to your knees and then
a diving slash.
Nice.
Brings out his butter knife.
He like runs and like slides on his knees with his sword out, and just like.
Man, all of us are Marcus today. Barrett, what's going on?
Has this guy even been touched yet? I don't think he has.
I think he was.
Touched.
Yeah.
Everyone's been
by the power of Marvin.
Just touched them all.
Okay.
He's reached into their hearts.
Oh, that's right. I got fireball too.
With the fire.
Fire. Yeah, right. Yeah. I'm actually not gonna shape shift again. I'm gonna shoot him with a firebolt of my own.
An auspicious choice.
Yes. Where's my spells? 21. I'm gonna assume that hits. Yeah. And that's 2d8. 8 plus. What do I add to that? Do you get damage to these?
No.
Cantrips normally.
No.
Okay, 8 damage. Probably.
8 damage?
Yep, sorry.
He's looking pretty rough. He is going to, he's going to launch himself at you and, chomp at your neck with his
right,
teeth.
My AC is 15 now.
Your AC is 15.
No.
He crits.
Not that it matters.
Your jugular.
Take a bite out of
yeah.
That.
Oh my god, that's wonderful.
Amazing.
You take 14 points of vital.
Nom nom.
Still
damage.
Up, but yeah, that hurt. That hurt a lot.
Of unsanitary mouth.
Yeah.
Marcus,
damage.
You see the shaman turn and disappear into the forest. The Inixes, inexplicably, like loyal puppies, turn and follow in his wake.
This guy?
Yes. Gone, gone, gone. Marvin?
Are they gone yet, or are they just starting to follow?
They turn and follow pretty quick.
So there's just two guys up?
There's one guy up.
One guy up?
I mean, there's one guy and Barrett. You could kill either.
I'm actually going to hold my turn until after Antoria.
Very well. Zathus.
Let's see. 5, 10, 15, 20.
This is ripe for parody.
I attack with my Smashable Short Sword.
Does okay.
16 hit.
16 will hit.
Alright. And sneak attack.
Describe for us your killing blow.
Which is.
It's close.
D6
yeah.
Strength.
He's got a lot of D6s coming your way.
Yeah. 3d6 plus my 1d6.
Let's see. 6, 10. 16 damage.
Nice. Describe for us.
Plus other.
That's
yeah.
Fine.
But
he
yeah.
Had less than 10. Describe for us how you kill this tiny little man clinging to
my throat.
I walk up to him, and because I'm sure he's still engaged with Barry, I walk to him, put my sword around his throat, and just pull it across.
Nice.
And then push him over.
Push his skull into me.
Ow! His head flops back.
Yeah.
You did it.
Yay.
Yay.
That's what I like to hear.
Yep.
Well.
I notify the party that the Enixes have scurried into the forest following Shaman Man. Shaman Man.
A man with the power of shamans.
Is there time? Is there time?
Rejected by the world.
Is it time for me to shift into a bear again and then follow them?
It's a bonus action.
Telek runs over to make sure that his friends are alright.
Okay.
Yeah. Friends, right?
Quickly. must hurry.
Yeah.
I'm gonna shout out to Talak. I'm gonna chase after them. Follow me. I know I can track them as a bear, and I'm gonna shift into a bear and.
Montorio's following along.
Run into the forest.
Okay.
I'm right there with Barrett.
Some of the Terran party follows behind you.
Okay.
This is.
Oh, is everyone going with us?
I'm sticking with everybody.
Yeah, I'm sticking with the party.
I think the rest of the. You said some of the Taric or whatever.
Terrans
are staying here.
Some of them are following
us. Some
of
the party followed us, but I guess some of them are staying in the clearing.
Marvin, you're going too?
Yep.
Well, some of them were still, like, unconscious on the ground.
Yeah.
So,
okay.
Telak and a couple of his friends were going to, like, revive them and unleash them.
Gotcha. I'm actually, as I catch up to Antoria, I'm going to slap him on the back and kind of, like, hold his shoulder. And I'm like, attaboy, I know you have it in ya. It feels good, doesn't it? Get the spells back in ya.
It's not my spells.
Shrug.
He seems very confused by what you're talking about. He's not denying it happened. He just, he's not really responding to you so much as talking to himself.
Sure.
Okay, give me a survival check, anyone that's trying to track this guy through the forest.
Tori is making his with disadvantage.
Natural one.
Still did better than his other one, though.
Does smelling apply to it?
Yeah.
I'm
still tracking the lizards.
I'm relying on Barrett.
Not so good this time.
Should be a pretty big pack.
14.
Lizards were here.
You're dealing with creatures that are pretty low to the ground. There's
fair.
Tons and tons of forest. There's no trails or anything like that here.
Okay.
What did you get? I'm
14
sorry.
This time.
14.
Trampled.
that's what we're trying to survive skill up.
I gotcha.
With a 14, it's going to be a little tough going. You guys are basically scampering through the forest trying to figure out which way you went. And it takes maybe about an hour before you find anything that's not just thick jungle.
Okay.
Over the course of this hour, it becomes clear that the Terrans have basically grouped up and followed behind you.
Okay.
You guys are chasing, but you can only chase quite so quickly.
Right. With wounded and...
Well,
or
as a group that's
yeah.
not
yeah.
experienced traveling through the jungle
right.
at all.
Right.
Besides which, you know, as a bear, you're able to figure out how to get through the jungle, but you're not exactly, like... ideally situated for
right. for
scampering through the forest.
Jungle traversing.
Exactly. But after that hour, you do come across another smaller clearing. A clearing that houses a structure... Well, I was about to say quite unlike anything that you've ever seen before, but as a matter of fact, it does look a little bit like the strange sort of egg-shaped building that you discovered back in the Ringing Mountains.
Mm.
Only this almost seems to be a town built of this stuff. There's just... an enormous organic looking, it's almost like a piece of coral. I mean, you guys haven't seen coral, but your players have. In that it's just sort of big and lumpy, and it seems not built so much as grown, but at the same time, what else could it be? It looks like there are maybe like a city door and some windows and spires for letting out smoke and that sort of thing. It's very strange.
Do we see halflings, like more of them?
No, you don't. But you do see what can only be the Inix's trail. The trail that you were looking for is very clear here because there's a lot of mud in the area, and you can see the big paw prints that these things would have left behind.
Did we still leave behind the...
I think everyone caught up to us.
They all caught up
right?
to us, is what
yeah,
you're saying?
They're clearly behind you somewhere. They're not necessarily in immediate conversational range.
Okay.
The paw prints lead up to the big door leading into the city.
I'm
or town.
Oh, Barrett's gonna Barrett's gonna stop. He's gonna turn around.
Bear,
I'm still Bear. I don't know if I'm a ship
bear to mine.
Point at the village as a bear. Like, and then I'll do. I'm actually gonna do a shrug thing. Like,
we need our supplies back.
No, well, I'm gonna have to shift back so I can talk.
Yeah, sorry, I don't have a message.
Yeah.
I usually would.
Alright, I'm shifting back. Shoot. Guys, I don't think we can take this. If this is a whole village of those halflings, this is suicide.
Less five.
Well, there could be hundreds
if we
of them.
Did a, well, we know where they are.
Right.
They're not going anywhere. If we rested and came back,
right.
we'd probably take them.
I mean, at the very least, I agree at this point that we probably do need to rest. But... we're so close to their village that there's nothing to say that they won't find us if we're resting right
Everyone
here.
Everyone can give me a perception check, by the way.
Side-based.
Yes.
Natural 20.
Nice. About time.
Natural 1, but that was my, but I've got advantage.
All right.
But that's not going to be enough.
Double 1-ish. 14. Okay,
what is it?
Perception.
Marcus, the environment here looks organic, organically weird. But all the same, there's no real signs of life like you'd expect at a village or something like that. It doesn't seem like anyone's been here for many, many years.
Ooh.
Short of the footprints that you see in the mud.
Okay. It seems like the village may be...
Short of the footprints?
Yes.
Halfling short.
Halflings, right.
Yeah, Marcus will say, it seems like the village isn't entirely functioning at normal capacity. It seems to be abandoned, possibly.
Hmm.
I'll do an investigation check, see if I can back that up that way.
Sure.
Got a 24.
24?
Wow. You know their history.
You know, this. If you hadn't encountered the building back in the Ringing Mountains, you never would have known what to compare this structure to. This, from what little you know of the Halflings, they live in huts and tree houses and stuff like this. This doesn't look like anything that... Halflings don't really have civilization, so far as you know, but this doesn't line up with anything that you know of what they're supposed to be like.
I agree. This is no halfling dwelling place.
Fat Wizard, someone wants to know if you're streaming later. You gotta want it.
Want what?
That thing that you want.
Let's go in and get the damn...
Anyway. Well, if you guys...
Here's your answer. Maybe. You have to tune in and find out.
Yeah. Just keep refreshing the page.
Yeah.
All
night long.
Let's go in.
Might I suggest that we send Zathus in, scout out, and then come back and report? He is the stealthiest of us all.
I'll go with him. And Toria vanishes in front of you.
So...
You can make a perception check if you're looking for him.
Yeah, I'm looking
for
him.
Sure, I'll lick him.
I will.
Did you say you'll lick him?
I'll lick him. Very good.
I got a 16.
I shifted back.
Perception 6.
Sadly. Kind of wish I had now.
14. That's probably did not do anything.
But I at least can talk to people.
I guess stealth check is with advantage when you're invisible.
That's a great question.
I have no idea how perception against invisibility looks. I looked it up earlier, but it... didn't seem to...
Natural 20!
I got a 25.
Marcus is like...
Well, perception isn't just sight unless there's something to it, so...
Right.
It was a perception.
Yeah, it is. I guess if I'm invisible, it's not sight-based anymore.
That's true.
That's not true. You can still perceive someone through that. You just have a
perceive his footprints on the grass.
Yeah, exactly.
This is signature aroma.
I'm not a bear.
Invisible conditions.
Yep.
Fucking index. Yeah. I'm sure you did this already.
Yeah, I did. It didn't give anything terribly helpful. It's like you didn't say like you need a DC 20 check to see or something like that.
Well, let's see if the Dungeon Master's Guide has that little present.
Well, I'm gonna say for sure we can't see him.
Yeah,
right?
You definitely can't. You can't.
Well, we
see
can perceive
him. Why not?
Of where you might be.
He's invisible.
I know. God.
Rules for invisibility.
For purposes of hiding, the character is heavily obscured. The location can be detected by any noise it makes or tracks it leaves.
Okay, so I'm gonna say that because we're in the jungle and because it's awesome, you basically have predator invisibility.
Right.
If you're perfectly still,
he's not moved yet.
But if you do move, then there's that little shimmer.
Like the hologram.
Yeah.
Hologram.
Yeah.
We'll just call it a stealth check with advantage.
Let's do
that.
Yeah.
Alright, so I'm not moving yet.
Alright.
So I'm perfectly invisible, apparently.
Like reptiles.
That happened, guys.
I'll turn to them and be like, that man is a beast.
I'm seeing him vanish. I'll turn on my heels and start walking towards the village.
You have heels?
I have heels.
Yes.
Everybody has heels.
It's part of your
anatomy.
But do you have high heels?
No.
I'll make the stealth check with advantage.
If I would say high heels.
Natural 20. I assume I still have predator mode.
Yeah.
Alright. Well,
I've just assumed
that
Zathus has actually been dressed as a cowboy this entire time. It just makes too much sense.
Where's that hat at? Get it back.
Assless chaps.
Yeah, 10 gallon.
No,
why?
Not all cowboys have assless chaps.
You can't be a cowboy. You can't have your ass out. I mean, you can't argue with that logic.
Well, we would try.
Okay.
Apparently, I'm wearing high heels with, I'm guessing, spurs, and I'm dressed like a cowboy.
Assless chaps.
Assless chaps.
And a hood and a cowl.
And a, yeah.
Yeah. All right.
You're a fashionable cowboy.
I am. Yeah. I'm very fashionable. Somebody do some fan art of that, please.
Oh, or don't.
In the chat.
I can
or
do
don't.
Right
do it.
Do it.
You do that. Other people are going to apparently sneak somewhere.
Yeah.
Where are you sneaking?
I guess so. We're going to approach the doors to the city, right?
That has the footprints in front of it, at least.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. How big are these doors?
It's 10 feet across.
Okay, but big enough. I mean,
are
small.
These sphincter doors?
They are sphincter doors. Watch the donations roll in.
Yeah.
The sphincter's
back.
Yeah. Like everyone last time.
Yeah.
Sphincter's back, everybody.
Okay, so I do an investigation check.
Okay.
I'll also do an investigation check.
21.
21. It's got me beat, though.
Yeah,
I'm pretty
25.
Sure.
Yeah.
Okay, you guys easily find the little indent next to the sphincter that appears to control
it. It's a butt. And...
Thank you. Incidentally, so,
everybody.
So these doors look like they're, you know, maybe three of you could stand shoulder to shoulder across and go in, which... A little majestic for halflings.
Yeah. I pay no attention to that.
Wow. All right.
Thanks for the description.
I'll just keep my fucking culture to myself.
Go be cultured somewhere else.
I'm on a mission, right?
Sure.
Mission Impossible theme in my head, you know.
Why do it in your head when we could do it?
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Yeah, hang on. I've got it here somewhere.
Do the Metallica version.
Or done.
There.
Yeah!
That's what
the Mission Impossible music.
Yeah, that's how it goes.
Anyways, so,
yes.
Do we push the button?
I'm waiting for you guys to tell me.
Alright, so I'm gonna push the button. Push the
button. Hear a voice next to you, stand away, I will do it.
Okay. Before I push the button.
A smoky hand appears, mage hand cast the other way, and pokes the indentation.
Okay. Nothing happens.
Antoria walks up to it himself and pushes it.
Okay.
Alright. Zathus kind of pokes his head in a little bit and checks his flanks inside.
Antoria does the same from the other side of the door.
Okay.
Perception, I guess?
Yep.
17.
Natural 20.
Alright.
It's dark inside, although there is a little bit of, like, ambient track lighting. It appears to open up into a large hallway.
Low light vision.
Dark vision.
Or dark vision.
Well, there's low light, so... There's a dark hallway leading in with mud prints going through the area.
Okay. It's a solid hallway?
It is. Okay. Entirely indoors.
Okay.
Let me go ahead and put a new map out.
Okay.
Yay, maps. Now, Marcus and I are still staying back, right?
Yeah.
Like, we're hanging out.
Oh, I'm not going either, yeah.
Oh, you didn't... Okay.
I didn't go either, yeah.
As far as you guys know, I'm the only one going inside.
I'm no good at stuff.
That's where he claimed he was.
Yeah.
But
so, you
but
guys...
He's appeared.
He's also
acting,
halfway back to Tyre.
He's also acting
meanwhile, the three of us
himself.
Are like, so, he's a lich now, right?
I have not stopped talking about how impressed I was with the abilities.
I think I got them all.
Crazy thing
God
is, if it wasn't
it.
For Antoria's morals, I'm pretty sure he could use his normal spells and the crazy stuff, but he's not using his normal spells. It's just just the one set.
Morals.
I'm very confused about looking at.
Alright, these are who we're after. These people aren't here. You're there. You're there.
Stay on target.
It's a green ditto. Yeah.
Alright.
Ditto!
I don't know what that Game Boy version sounds like.
I was trying to do it, but I have no idea if I was close or not. Game Boy was a long time ago.
Yeah.
What was the game where we went...
You
need more digital
sound. Yeah,
like,
you need to get up to like the DS's or something before you get a decent...
No, I don't even DS, man. It's like... Freaking very digital sounding, very computer sounding.
Yeah.
I wonder if they just never updated them from the Game Boy versions for nostalgia.
Possibly.
So I believe we've got the clearing there leading inside, and then...
Is this the whole village?
I think it is.
Oh, okay.
Is it like covered in trees?
Oh, that's the background of the map. Okay.
Yep.
Are we slowly uncovering the map?
We are!
I hope I got that piece right.
Mini map just fogged up. Yeah, right?
Fog of war.
So this, so judging by the map here, the hallway goes in a couple directions.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
That is correct.
Which way do the footprints go?
They go off to your left as you're facing that.
Okay, so this way.
And you said it's dark in here, right?
Well, it's dark, but there's strange blue lighting that you can't really place the source of down around the floor.
Good enough for a human to see, or is a human in trouble?
A human could see about as well as they could at night.
Okay.
Before we venture that way, I'm just gonna kind of come around this corner and see what I can see down this direction.
Okay. Yeah, there's gonna be a fair bit of me looking at the undersides of these. Yeah, that way. Cool. So there's
playing
a path
a roguelike
like that, and there's another path that goes that way, I believe.
Okay, I'm gonna kind of inch forward and peek around that corner as well.
Okay.
Toria's staying relatively close.
And be like, I'm gonna whisper and be like, and Toria, are you with me?
Of course.
I just wanna make sure that we're alone.
We're alone now. Yeah, just the two of us. We can make it if we. All
right, sorry, that can't be right.
Uh oh.
I've borked it up already. That's not even a word.
Nope.
Sort of a word.
Yeah. That's fine. You know what? Let's just move it.
Bork.
Like generally towards the middle. We won't worry quite as bad. Cool.
Okay, and I can see these like these are doors.
These are additional sphincters set within the walls.
Okay.
So many sphincters.
This is very.
I mean, there's
odd.
Only three.
This place seems extensive. Maybe we should have the others with us.
I'm worried that they're gonna go in guns blazing or whatever.
I wouldn't worry.
That's
about
a very
it.
Apt worry.
That's a certainty, I would think.
Yes.
We can explore a bit further if you'd like.
Yes.
This place seems to be set on fire.
Oh no! This place seems to be lacking a lot of fire. Let's remedy that. Let's continue down here and see if we can follow these tracks.
Right behind you.
So.
Oh boy. Bill, would you look underneath where Zathan's standing and tell me what letter is marked here?
B! Oh, A.
A.
They're heading towards A is where they're going. They're going towards A.
Good.
A is for happiness.
Long A. All
right.
Oh, man.
And footprints go, I guess, this way or this way?
As a matter of fact, they seem to continue off this way.
Okay.
Oh, you know what? I see what's going on here. All right, I'm going to break your immersion real quick.
Oh, no.
Earthquake!
There have been earthquakes in this region.
There's one right now.
Oh, God.
That, I think, is what I meant to do.
I'm so confused now.
I'm sorry.
My immersion?
Halflings are super dangerous, guys.
It's like Persona 1.
They can warp reality.
They have the power to reshape dungeons.
Yeah.
This one goes over on
yeah,
this
there we go.
Okay.
So you guys are here.
Yeah.
Okay.
Technically, you're here going this way.
Yes.
Okay.
That makes
sense. So the footprints go this way, then?
Yes.
Okay. Got it.
So, okay, so I guess we
and what letter is there, Bill?
We ventured this way. And
okay. Yes. No, just...
E?
Okay.
E.
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 It occurs to me that we didn't know what the letters meant. They could have been on top.
Listen.
Could have been halfling higher.
Then I've been like... What is this strange E shape on the
ground? True.
Oh, that's not there.
These runes on the ground.
I scribble out the E.
I've never seen these before.
Okay. So cautiously continuing down the halls, checking my checking around corners before we
sure. Checking your six.
Checking my six, yeah.
Make Toria's sure. Looking around.
Make sure that
okay.
I see Antoria's holographic predator like presence.
There's a halfling standing in the hallway in front of you. You could swear he wasn't there just a moment ago. He's not dressed like any of the ones that you've seen most recently.
Hmm.
Does it look like he sees us?
Absolutely, he's looking right at you.
He's looking right at us.
He's like waving.
Yeah, he's one of us.
Actually, he holds up a hand and speaks in a language you don't understand.
What language is that?
I don't know. What languages do you speak?
Common, Elvish, Draconic.
Nope.
I speak Common, Elvish. Where am I? Common, Elvish, Gith, Primordial, and
Thrycreen.
I raise my hand as well.
He doesn't react.
Antoria, suggestions?
I don't understand him either.
He disappears.
You didn't see me shrug.
Yeah, I'm looking back at nothing.
Do you tell him you shrugged?
No, I'm as puzzled as you are. He didn't seem hostile.
Indeed, that was a very strange interaction.
Oh, fuck. Did we need another earthquake?
No, nothing. Okay. Doesn't matter.
None of this matters.
We're pretty deep inside.
Yes, so there's not going to be an earthquake.
That was a strange exchange. It seemed like he was trying to tell us something, but I'm not entirely sure what.
What are the rest of you guys up to?
He's totally a lich, guys, right? He's totally a lich.
I'm talking about how cool Antorius' abilities are. All
right.
Listening to him with kind of fake listening. Yeah, I saw it.
I swear to God, he's like black and red,
yeah,
and then his eyes were like solid red. It was amazing. Or was it
black?
One of those colors. No, I know.
Oh, yeah, okay,
like,
okay,
I get it.
I don't know if it's
red or black. I don't know, it doesn't matter. It's super cool.
Barrett is very concerned for the future of our party. For the Squad of Truth.
I think we could probably harness whatever what's happening with him.
Go up to an engine of some kind.
I think that he's probably in like halfway between lich and human. If we find a way to like keep him there, that would be perfect.
So, based on our knowledge of phylacteries, the lich comes back in his normal form, the way he was before. After the process is complete. That seems a little bit dangerous to me.
I don't understand this whole phylactery.
It's like a kindergarten, but different.
Yeah.
I don't understand what a phylactery is, so...
Phylactery.
Based on what we've been told so far, it sounds like the lich comes back if he completes this process of phylacterizing.
What's the phylacterize? What does that process look like?
I have no idea.
Like?
It's magical and...
Wait, are you saying that Antoria's got a secret quest that he's got to complete?
I'm saying that I think Antoria is becoming a lich. The lich that we fought before.
I don't know what could have given you that
idea. Yarnith.
Yes, Yarnith. I think when he gets back, we're going to have to talk about if he should still be conscious and allowed to roam free like he is right now.
Are you suggesting that we kill him?
No. I'm suggesting that we beat him into submission and unconsciousness.
Well, I mean, I tell you what, 6 hours ago I would have wholeheartedly agreed, but I think he's got a very real possibility. You know, he's got potential, that kid.
I think he's dangerous and possibly a loose cannon.
I'd like it.
wait, loose cannon's the problem? Hold on a minute.
No, well.
I don't know. Barrett
knows who he's talking to. He's not going to change his mind.
The only thing is, if he can learn how to control it, I can probably help him with that. We could. Really...
Yes, I'm sure you wish you could turn into a lich too, but. I don't think this is a good idea.
All I'm saying is, I think we're a little preemptive in the whole beating to submission. Like, he's coming into his own.
I mean, at least he isn't defiling shit all over the place. I'll give you that much.
So he could be getting better.
I don't know about that.
I mean, wouldn't you not consider this getting better? He went from destroying the forest to not destroying the forest.
But that was you destroying the forest with your fireballs.
Right, but we're not talking about what I did or didn't do.
I have a joke if anyone wants to hear it.
Let's hear it.
What's a lich's favorite sandwich shop?
The Twitch.
Yes.
We flitch.
Jerk.
Wow.
A bunch of giant bees fly towards you.
Marcus, what do you think about this whole beating?
Oh, he's submission? Serious about the bees.
Of course I'm serious about the bees!
They're right there.
Sorry, I wasn't listening.
He wants to beat Mentori into submission.
I think he's no longer safe being conscious and able to roam free.
I guess they're really flying towards Zathus.
Yeah.
Well,
what? Oh yeah, that's true. They're being attacked by bees. Oh.
Bees! 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 Oprah, no! Was that the halfling we saw?
Oh, Oprah halfling?
Could be.
It's a lot of bees.
I'm gonna assume that only you and me have seen that gif you're talking about. No one else knows
what
it
is. I've seen it. Everyone has seen that.
I don't think I've seen that.
I've seen it.
Yeah. Okay, almost everyone has seen it.
There's one where Oprah's like, is it the free cars one?
Yeah, exactly.
Everybody gets a car! Yeah. She's like, yeah. Instead someone overrode it and was like, everyone gets bees! Bees for everyone! She shoots like bees out of her mouth at like everyone and attacked by bees.
That's awesome.
And it's funny because people cheering and some other people in agony and screaming, so it actually just kind of works. There's also one where Tom Cruise is electrocuting her on like,
Bees. Oh, Donkey Kong Country.
Give me an initiative roll.
Give me an initiative roll.
Just one.
Just one.
You're not rolling for him.
I know, right?
18.
18.
12.
I'm going to say that you go in that order, then.
Where are the bees?
Antoria, you're first.
Are they bees or hornets?
Mm.
They're giant wasps.
I was going to say, if they're bees, they should die after they sting them once.
You should die after they sting you once.
Oh. That's not very nice.
What squares are they? Are they like 10 by 10s?
Mind your own business.
Are they 10 by 10s?
They are not.
Oh, because they're kind of... Yeah, they're square position. Yeah,
I just put them in the hallway.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
There you go.
Yeah.
There we go. There, they each take up a square.
There you go. Something bumps beside you. And you see a red and black orb of energy appearing right about here, and it releases a blast that way, catching the first three bees in the thunder wave.
Bees!
DC 15 con saves.
Oh man, bees don't have good con. Oh man, yes they do!
They all pass?
Yeah, they do.
Alright, well the damage is... Jesus, 4. Okay.
Why'd you forego the damage?
What? No.
Anything else?
I'm stepping back, so I guess that first one could make an opportunity attack if it wished.
Against an invisible target.
Even though it missed, I'm visible again, by the way.
Okay. Oh, okay.
He cast a spell.
Yeah, I walk back behind you, but as that one attacks, a purple wall of runes appears, and it doesn't seem to even hit the wall of runes, but it did happen.
Zathus?
Okay. Okay.
Meanwhile, it's just like more and more like a skull with black eyes.
It's had some work done.
That was a shield reaction, by the way. I'm just casting it to a few other things.
Alright, I guess I'm going to attack this one here in the front.
Okay.
Does a 25 hit?
Yes!
I'd hope so. If it doesn't, you guys got some problems.
This is a fucking bee, man. Okay, and I'm guessing since Centauri is behind me, he doesn't count.
No. Sorry.
Yes!
All right.
6 points of damage.
Woohoo!
Can I do perception to see if I hear any of this?
Sure. You might have heard the thunder wave. It's pretty loud.
9.
Mm-mm. Well, not a whole lot going on there.
And I guess I'll use my bonus action to
disengage
behind Antoria.
Okay.
Antoria doesn't seem too bothered.
Yeah.
By you being behind him.
I got a 24 to perception, but
to what?
To hear, I guess, if we hear stuff.
Okay.
I mean, if he rolls it, I might as well too.
Two of the bees fly forward and launch their stingers in your general direction, Antoria.
Alright, AC is 17 temporarily.
Okay. One of them hits.
Alright.
You take 5 points of stinger damage. Give me a con save.
Do I still need it with the orange shield blocking all five?
No, I guess not.
Antoria's normal orange shield appears, but it seems to be threaded with purple.
It's like a nerf ball. We're all like, I'm worried he's a lich. This could be really bad. Meanwhile, like,
the other
like,
two dart over
pretty.
Your head and sting their way towards Zathus.
I guess they're on the other side of him after this?
They're kind of over both of you, actually. They're sort of just between you and the ceiling. What's your AC right now?
16.
16. One will hit. You take 5 points of stinger damage.
So all four of them, like, over us?
Just those two.
Oh, just those two.
I use my reaction to half it, so that would be three.
Give me a con save.
If you half five, is that three? Rounds up, right?
Two. Rounds down.
Just
down.
Rounds
always
down.
Rounds down.
Yep.
Okay, that's right. I forget about that. Con save, yes. Seven.
You take 10 points of poison damage. In your blood.
I already used my reaction, so...
10 blood damage.
Antoria.
How high is the ceiling?
4 feet.
Alright, he emits a blast of thunder directly, black thunder directly above him.
Okay.
Trying to shove them into the ceiling.
You guys outside can give me a perception check to see if you hear that.
And it's another DC 15 con save.
18.
16.
One. Dude, it was like red and black. And
wrapped up
amazing.
Tight. One of them saves.
All right.
Stop talking so loud. It hurts my ears.
Damage is 15 and 7. 15 for the one that didn't save, and it gets flung into the ceiling, I suppose. I don't know if that does any damage, but...
Nah.
Okay. And I will stay put where I'm at.
Good deal. Zathus?
Alright, I will attack... One of the ones overhead, I guess this one that's closest to me.
Sure.
Does a 12 hit?
It does.
Alright.
Woohoo!
1, 2, 3, 4.
Give him the business.
Yep. 8, 10, 11, 16 points of damage.
Ah, it explodes into bits of goo and wing.
One of the ones that was above us?
Yep.
Nice.
Alright, the one above you will sting back towards Zathus and hit. And let's just go ahead and roll the other two that are stinging towards Antoria. It's cocked. And one will hit you. So, Zathus, you take 3, so you really take 1, I'm guessing.
Yep.
Give me another con save.
Would a 17 block the one that hit me?
It would not have, as a matter of fact.
Okay, hold on.
Oh, wait, what a 7? Did I hit on a 17 or less? Is what
did you hit 16 or less?
I hit 18.
Okay, then, yeah, never mind.
Okay,
sorry.
Yeah. You take 5 points of damage.
Shield blocks all of it still.
Okay.
Con save is 7.
7! 10 points of poison damage. That's what poison sounds like.
I'm not liking this poison.
Antoria!
Alright. Antoria, there's 2 in front of him.
Yes.
If I back up a step, would I be able to catch all 3?
Sure.
Alright, I will back up a step and then catch all 3 in a thunder wave.
Sounds good.
DC 15 times.
I mean, lich
speaking
wave.
Of sounds good, everyone can give me a perception check to see if they
sounds
hear.
Sounds good.
Lich wave.
I heard you.
12.
I'm gonna say it again.
Jesus, I roll for shit on this spell. 6 or 3, but they get shoved back 10 feet if they fail.
All of them save.
Jesus.
15.
So 3 damage each. That's it. Alright. And then I will actually step back where I was so that Zathus is
Say this.
Helped.
Okay. I'll step forward and attack this one. Here.
Okay.
We know that's going to hit
17.
17 hits.
Yeah. 3, 4. Let's see. 8. 11, 16 points of damage.
16, he explodes.
The other one that was above us?
Yep.
Okay.
The other two swarm towards Zathus.
Oh, poop.
Both hits.
Poop.
So one hits for 5 points of damage.
Okay, so that's 2.
And then the other hits for 8.
That's 4, so that's 6.
I think you can only react to one
person. Yeah.
The big one, but...
Well, you chose to dodge the first one, so you take 8.
Okay, yep.
And then give me a con save for both of those.
So I take 8 and 2? Right.
That is accurate.
10.
46 and 2.
Just... ahead of you.
Do I just gotta do one con save?
No, you have to take one for each.
Yeah, one for each, okay. So... okay, I got a... 18 and an 11.
All right, you managed to... You're getting the hang of this poison thing. You managed to shrug it off.
All
right. Getting used to getting stabbed.
Antoria.
Antoria releases...
Doesn't feel so good, does it?
Antoria releases yet another black and purple blast of thunder wave.
Okay.
DC 15 saves, as usual.
No problem.
Yeah, apparently.
Man, if only Marvin could
no
see
problem.
This. I mean, Marvin would be frothing at the mouth.
Boarding.
Yeah!
Jesus, the spell.
Oh, man.
They get knocked back 10 feet for what that's worth.
Sure.
Yeah. Can I make an opportunity attack on the one that's being knocked back? I don't know what that works.
No.
Forget it.
Not.
Okay.
Can I try hearing that?
Sure.
You're Antoria, ask a dumb question about opportunity attacks.
Gosh, I'm rolling worse and worse as we go on.
Mm-hmm. And then it was like...
Zathus is taking home movies for him.
Yeah.
Zathus turns to Antoria and says, "We need to end this quickly. I don't know how much longer I can last."
I'm and working on it.
Pulls out his short bow, I mean his crossbow, and takes aim at this one here.
Okay.
I did knock them out of sneak attack range, unfortunately.
Yeah.
Well.
It's
a
7.
I'm just imagining like the whole structure shaking like every 3 seconds and like no one noticing.
Yeah. Because he's like,
and then he was like, "Red right now!" And then
did you see what
like,
he did? It was awesome!
15 hits. No, as a matter of fact, it's noticeably solid in here. Perhaps more solid than any of the construction you've seen in the major cities.
Note that in a quiet corner of my mind. What's left of my mind.
Yeah. Absorb some fucking culture.
10. 10 points of damage.
10 points of damage, it explodes.
And then I will use my bonus action to disengage as far
sure.
back as I can.
The last one zings its way towards
the Five
Antoria.
More bees come from behind you.
That's not going to hit. Your turn.
All right. Toria glares at it and just points a finger and a blue and white ray of light shoots towards it. Does a 17 hit?
Yes.
Let's see if
is unhappy.
I don't like D8s. They roll shit for damage, it seems. Yes, 7 points of cold damage and its movement speed drops.
It manages, you cover it in a strange blue and white crystal and it collapses to the ground and shatters. Done.
Yes. Quickly, let's get you out of here.
Yes.
He's actually leading the way back out.
I think
it's actually that
this
way.
Yeah,
the map shook up a bit and you guys ended up back at the other end.
Zathus emerges out of the doorway. Falls to his knees.
Victoria stops and is trying to help him, but doesn't really have anything other than medicine skill.
Oh, you could drain his life.
drain his life.
Aren't looking to. Merit, over here.
Do we hear that?
Yeah, absolutely.
All right, do I have to roll for that?
No, he's right here.
We're right there.
Are we right there? I thought we were a little bit further away than that. Anyway,
you're there.
I'll shove him aside while he's talking about how great Antorius is and walk over here and be like, what?
What do you mean, what? Look at him!
He looks fine.
You look
poison balloon.
He has like a bunch of stings and he looks poisoned and he's like green.
Yeah.
Like green. I can fix that.
Growth coming off your face.
Is he still poisoned then? Or
I think
how
it was
does
just
that...
immediate damage.
Poison isn't a status effect in 5e.
Right.
Unless I specifically...
It's a disadvantage, right?
Yeah, that's the base status effect.
That's the worst representation of poison ever.
Sorry.
I'm going to heal you for, quite a bit. Fuck it is, cure wounds. 12. 12, and then, I don't know, should I heal you again? What do you think?
That gets me up to 16 hit points.
That's about where I'm at right now.
Do you have any hit
actually.
Dice left?
I do have hit dice left, yeah. Take a short rest.
Yeah, guys, I think we're going to have to rest.
Short one.
Yeah, a short rest.
Let's not waste much time.
All right, we'll back off and begin a short rest.
Okay.
So.
Yay.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Hit die.
You restore hit dice on a short rest.
No, you can use them, but you can't restore them.
I don't think I've used
two. Mm-hmm.
The Terrans have entirely caught up with you by now.
Five.
Okay.
I just want to clarify. Your email said short rest, right?
Yes.
Okay.
You are mighty.
Just want to make sure.
You've got some stuff going on in your brain.
I'm out of hit dice.
Oops.
I guess after the short
rest...
I'm
also out of hit dice. But I heal quite a bit.
I'll tell the guys what we encountered or whatever.
You're giving an inspiring speech of some kind, I assume.
No. Plus 10 HP to everyone.
No. that's Marvin's department. I just say we were doing fine. It seemed pretty empty. We came across this strange halfling who seemed to be trying to communicate with us, but we couldn't understand him, and then he just disappeared.
Do you remember what he said? Like, what he spoken?
Memory check to try and imitate what was said to us?
Sure.
All
right. Intelligence check.
Okay.
Bill, can I get those bees?
Got a
22.
22? You've got a pretty clear idea of what he looked like.
Was it druidic or undercommon?
I'll try repeating back a few syllables as best I can to see if he can recognize it as either
I
of those.
I think those are the only two we haven't tried yet.
It's pretty tricky.
Okay.
But he seemed...
It's hard to get my tongue around
it. I remember he held his hand up, and I'm not sure if it was in greeting or if in halting, and began to make some other gestures that didn't make any sense.
This sounds like a very strange place. It's already strange enough with these weird sphincter things.
And then we were attacked by bees.
Is it the door? Did the door just say hi?
No.
Hey, you're talking about me. I'm the door.
We were attacked by bees, which makes me think this is some sort of hive.
Are we okay over there?
No, I just think bees are funny.
Oh.
Wasps.
Oh, bees pollinating flowers.
Doing
stuff. So hilarious.
Anyway.
Stinging things. And
well,
dying.
It sounds like this is something we should all go in together then for.
Agreed.
There are many paths we weren't able to check. We started off scouting around to make sure that the place truly was deserted as Marcus thought.
Well,
which we then started tracing out the Enixes. And
Marvin is tuned out by now. He's listening to his Walkman.
No, he's just staring at Antorius like, "Oh, you're so awesome!
Yeah,
so cool.
He loves Antoria now."
Meanwhile, Antorius seems to have a headache.
Well, now that we've rested for a bit, I feel up to helping. I definitely...
Let's go already.
Yeah, okay. As the man said...
Good.
Yes?
An inspiring speech about, like, the overwhelming power of Antoria and Marvin. In the back lines, we see enemies coming, nuking them. We've got Marcus in front holding them off. And that's all we need to win every victory, but you other two are, like, super important also.
I'm just there to sponge, man. I'm a giant sponge.
And you transform into a giant sponge.
There we go.
Wad.
And then after, the speech only lasts about 5 minutes, and the other 5 minutes is kind of, like, poking Antoria for, like, how'd you do that? Like, does it... What does it feel like? How'd you learn this stuff? Do you think you can teach me some of it?
Senpai.
Senpai.
Oh, Senpai.
Like,
teach me what you know.
Is that the lich?
He refuses to notice
power?
You.
Leave me
does
alone.
It hurt?
Oh, he sounds just like Senpai.
I have a headache. I've had a headache for the last 3 hours. Of course it hurts.
Do you think that's what caused you to become more powerful?
Please,
are
just
you
leave
a
me alone.
Saiyai!
Do you still have that scroll? I want to look at it.
You might be the biggest fool I've ever met. Leave me alone!
It sounds just like Senpai, actually.
Anyway, Alright, guys, I'm ready to go in if you guys are ready.
Ventoria's already walking towards it.
Alright, then we're ready.
Great.
Alright.
Alright.
Barret's all right. having another second thought about making him unconscious, but.
Okay.
Let's not do that.
You guys approach the Grand Sphincter.
I think we need all the help we can get right now. Alright.
Marcus enters.
Into the sphincter, everybody!
Ventoria's right behind him.
Did you have any indication of which way to go in here?
Ventoria points the way the footprints were going.
As a matter of fact, the footprints are gone. The floor seems pristine.
Well, there were footprints here. I must have waited.
This is a dirt, like a dirt.
Guys,
so there's lots of mud outside, like.
Oh,
thick.
I might be able to track them again, like I did before, but I won't.